What is up, guys? Tava here, and today I'm going to be showing you a super easy way to make super cinematic and beautiful looking hyperlapses using just your iPhone in the built-in camera app. So this is how it's done. So all of those hyperlapses that you just saw were shot entirely on an iPhone using the built-in camera app, which is just insane to me. The stabilization they have in these is really impressive nowadays. The other week I made a video with this technique included into it, but today I'm going to be going into a bit more depth on how I shoot these hyperlapses and how you can make them look really good as well. Most of my iPhone hyperlapses that you just saw were shot handheld, but if you do use a gimbal, you can get a bit more stable shots, although I wouldn't say it's necessary. But like I said, these hyperlapses are extremely easy to create, so here are my steps to make the best iPhone hyperlapses. First, you need to open up the camera app and swipe a few times to the right to get to the time-lapse feature. From there, you can either just start shooting in one direction consistently and call that good, but what I like to do to create the most dynamic hyperlapses is to actually lock the exposure and set it on a point that I want to focus on. You honestly should already be locking your exposure so it doesn't fluctuate as your hyperlapse is going on, so what we're going to do is just hold on a point until it brings up this little square box. From there, you can adjust the exposure by pulling up and down on this little sun-like icon. But personally, what I like to do is set my exposure box on something that I want to focus on. So say I want to keep the center frame on this palm tree, I'm just going to click on the palm tree, hold down until the box goes around it, and then through my entire hyperlapse, I will keep that box centered on the palm tree. And this just creates for the most creative and beautiful looking hyperlapses. And again, you can keep this exposure box around anything in your scene. So for example, you could do it on a building as well, around a plant, or anything that you really want to keep centered in your frame, but it allows for a much more smooth moving shot that looks much better. And another tip is just to walk really smoothly and slowly with your legs bent to try and reduce the motion that happens in the phone so you don't get a lot of wobble in the corners. The time-lapse itself does do good stabilization, but it's not perfect, so you really want to make your body motions complement the camera shot you're trying to capture. But honestly, that's it. Open the camera app, go to the time-lapse feature, lock your exposure, walk slowly, and you get these amazing hyperlapses that look like some of these examples I'm going to show you right now. But anyway, that's it for today. That's just a super easy tip that I love to do and I think looks fantastic. And anyone can do this, and everyone should be doing it because it looks great. If you like this video, be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you all next time.